Hello everyone, welcome to new IAS daily current affairs program. The topics for today on 1st October 2018 are S-400 Triumph, INS Arihant, Competition Law Review Committee, Nobel Prize, and for the map session we have Macedonia, and last we have PQRS. Coming to the very first topic, S-400 Triumph. It was in news because India approved to buy 5 S-400 Triumph air defense system from Russia. The program was approved earlier in the week by the Indian government's highest defense approval body, that is Cabinet Committee on Security, which is headed by Prime Minister. A formal government-to-government contract is expected to be announced during the 19th India-Russia summit on October 5th. We'll see the details of S-400 Triumph. It is considered one of the most advanced long-range defense systems in the world, and it is capable of intercepting and destroying airborne targets at a distance of up to 400 km and can simultaneously engage up to 6 targets. Also, it can hit targets at a height of up to 30 km. Each S-400 unit consists of tracking and search radar system, 8 launchers, 112 guided missile and command and support vehicles. Russia remains the largest defense supplier to India, but its share in the Indian market has fallen sharply. As I said, there will be India-Russia summit on October 4th and 5th, and we'll see the details of that. It is an annual summit meeting between the Prime Minister of India and the President of Russian Federation. It is actually the highest institutionalized dialogue mechanism under the strategic partnership between India and Russian Federation. The Russian President will pay visit to New Delhi on October 4th and 5th, and that is for the 19th India-Russia annual summit. It is a bilateral summit. That's all about S-400 Triumph. And coming to our next topic, that is INS Arihant. It was in news because India's first nuclear-armed submarine is now ready for full-fledged operations. Alright, now we'll see the news in detail. The INS Arihant, that is the first of the 5 nuclear missile submarine, and it belongs to class SSBN, which I'll detail you later on. A Russian diving support ship called RFS Apron, which is actually a submarine rescue vessel that will accompany Arihant on the deep sea dives. It is because India currently does not possess a submarine rescue vessel of this class. The Navy Submarine Design Bureau is also presently working on a new class of nuclear powered attack submarine, that is SSN. Now we will see what is SSN and SSBN. I said Arihant belongs to the class SSBN. What is SSN? SSN is Submersible Ship Nuclear, and SSBN is Submersible Ship Ballistic Missile Nuclear. We'll see the details of both SSN and SSBN. SSN is used to attack for the nearby distance, and it is actually a war prone because it looks to destroy the enemy ships. It is used for general purpose, like to attack submarines, whereas SSBN is quite different. It is actually used to launch missile to attack far distance, and it keeps the position secret from other ships or submarines. Because of that, it is used for strategic attacks only. Okay, it carries out strategic attacks. About INS Arihant, as I said, it belongs to class SSBN. It is a nuclear submarine which is capable of carrying nuclear-tipped ballistic missile. Thus, it belongs to class SSBN. This was built with Russia's help under Advanced Technology Vessel Project. And this provides second strike capability to India. Second strike capability means it is actually a country's assured ability to respond to a nuclear attack with powerful nuclear retaliation against the attacker, which means this will allow India to retaliate against an enemy who managed to destroy the rest of the nuclear arsenal in a first strike. So this INS Arihant provides second strike capability. Remember this word, okay? That's all about INS Arihant. Now we'll move to the next topic, that is Competition Law Review Committee. It was in news because the government has constituted a Competition Law Review Committee to review the Competition Act 2002. This act established the Competition Commission of India, which aims to prevent the activities that have an adverse effect on competition in India. This act extends to whole of India except Jammu and Kashmir. Now we'll see a few details about Competition Commission of India also. It implements and enforces competition policy. Okay, it implements and enforces competition policy. Also, it prevents and punishes anti-competitive business practices by firms and unnecessary governmental interference in the market. Also, this is to protect the interest of consumers and to ensure freedom of trade in India. This aims to prohibit practices that restrict free trading and also competition. This, as I said before, it is to provide opportunity to entrepreneurs for the competition in the market, and it also aims to prevent the anti-competition practices to promote a fair and healthy competition system in the market. Almost all the objectives are very similar. Okay, now we will see details about review committee also, Competition Review Committee. It is a 9-member committee which is chaired by the Secretary of Corporate Affairs Ministry, and the chairpersons of Competition Commission of India and Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India are its members. The mandate of the committee is to review the Competition Act or rules and regulations and all, and it also look into international best practices in the competition field. This will study other regulatory regimes which overlap with the Competition Act also. Coming to our next topic, that is Nobel Prize. It was in news because today Nobel Prize for Medicine was announced, and also the Nobel Prize for Literature have been put off till 2019, and the winner for 2018 Nobel Prize for Literature will be declared along with the 2019 winner. Okay, now about Nobel Prize. It is actually a set of 6 annual international awards. This will be awarded for outstanding contributions for chemistry, literature, peace, physics, and physiology or medicine. This Nobel Prize is awarded by the Royal Swedish Academy of Science, which awards the Nobel Prize for chemistry and physics. It is a Nobel Prize for Physics and Chemistry is awarded by Royal Swedish Academy of Science. There are certain conventions of this award which are like they are not given or they are not awarded posthumously. But if a person is awarded the prize and dies before receiving it, then the prize may be presented. It is not shared among more than 3 people. Although a Nobel Prize for Peace can be awarded to an organization of more than 3 people. Except for Peace Prize, Nobel Prize are presented in Stockholm, that is in Sweden. And this prize is usually awarded in the ceremony on 10th December, which is the anniversary of Nobel's death. And Peace Prize is presented in Oslo, that is in Norway. Today, James P. Allison and Tasaku Honjo won Nobel Prize for Medicine. And they have been awarded this prize for the discovery that the body's immune system can be harnessed to attack cancer cells. For this discovery, they have been awarded the Nobel Prize for Medicine in 2018. Now we have map-aided program, and we will be seeing Macedonia. Macedonia is in news because the people of Macedonia have gone for a referendum on whether to change its name to Republic of North Macedonia or not. This has got a long way back history. When Macedonia declared independence during the breakup of Yugoslavia in 1991, Greece objected to its new neighbor's name. Greece objections in the UN forced them to refer to the new country as the former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia. The results of referendum is that more than 90% backed the name change, but the issue was that only around a one-third of Macedonians took part in this referendum. That was the issue. There will be a name change, and this would resolve decades-old disputes with Greece, which had blocked its membership bids in the European Union and NATO. Hopefully, this will be resolved very soon. Coming about the location of Macedonia, it is actually a country in the Balkan Peninsula. It is located in the southeast Europe. It is, as I said, it is one of the successor state of the former Yugoslavia. It is actually a landlocked country, that is Kosovo to the northwest, Serbia to the north, and Bulgaria in the east, Greece to the south, and Albania to the west. Thus, it is a landlocked country. And last, we have PQRS, that is previous question revision series. We'll see the question. A genetically engineered form of brinjal known as the BT brinjal has been developed. The objective of this is option A, to make it pest resistant, option B, to improve its taste and nutritive qualities, option C, to make it drought resilient, option D, to make it its shelf life longer. Now, which is the objective? This is a question from 2011 prelims. Hopefully, you all know the answer. It's a very simple question. That time, way back in 2011, there was an issue like developers of BT violated India's biodiversity laws and all. There were many NGOs protesting against the BT brinjal development and all. That was the issue. We'll see what is BT brinjal. Actually, this is created by inserting a crystal protein gene, that is Cry1AC, from the soil bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis into the genome of various brinjal cultivars. BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis. The BT brinjal has been developed to give resistance against lepidopteran insects. Thus, our answer for the question is to make BT brinjal is developed to make it pest resistant. Option A is the right answer, to make it pest resistant. For the daily current affairs material, you can click on the link given below. That's all for today, and thank you for watching.